Hey, what's up everybody? It's DJ Jer here with Shop Time, and we're working with audio right now. If you have not seen my initial review on the Electro-Voice EKX, make sure you check it out. We did a review on the 18 subs and the 15 tops. We since then have gotten the 12 tops. Haven't done any reviews on those though, but make sure you check out my initial review on the EKX. I think you'll enjoy it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it into cardioid mode, and what that does is instead of the sound basically filling all the way around and hitting the DJ, what it does is it's going to fill the sound and the audio where the audience is gonna be at. So instead of the sound being in a circle motion, which your sub is actually obviously dispersing all the way around, where more of your other sub or your other speakers are more directional. With the sub, what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn a circle into more of an arrow or a blunted arrow shape, which is going to basically hit my audience, which is up here. So instead of this, it's going to kind of compress it so it pushes the audio forward. So what we're gonna do is we're actually going to get these fired up here for you. And we're gonna plug in our subs. I've got two subs. And a couple notes you wanna keep in mind is you have to make sure that they're the same style of sub. So this is the EKX. You don't wanna mix the EKX with the ETX. You wanna make sure that you're using the correct one that Electro-Voice has made. So you have EKX, make sure your top is also gonna be EKX. So what we're going to do is the bottom one is gonna be facing backwards. And if you were at Mobile Beat, you would have seen this setup when we did the stage for Mobile Beat with Jason Janai, Electro-Voice, and also the Entertainment Experience. All everything on the bottom was facing backwards, which is basically pushing the sound back this way. So we're gonna go in, we're actually going to turn it into cardioid mode. And by doing so, we're going to go into the menu by pushing the menu, and you'll see where it says location. When you click on location, you push the button in, and you can change it from normal to cardioid mode. And then you have to push that button again to lock it in. Scroll back up, oops, I'm sorry. Cardioid mode, scroll back up to exit, and then basically it's ready to go, it's locked in. And you'll notice, okay, so once we have it locked in, and you'll notice that it's locked in, when you look at location, you'll see it still says cardioid mode. So once we exit out, we'll get back to our normal menus to see the amount of decibels and also the output that it's giving. And then we're gonna grab our second speaker, get that plugged in. And then it's important that these speakers are actually stacked on top of each other. And that top speaker is the one that's going to be facing your crowd. It's gonna look like this. And then the menu on the back is actually gonna be in normal mode, so nothing's gonna change with that. The one thing you wanna keep in mind is if you have the frequency set on this one at a certain level, you wanna make sure the frequencies match the same thing here. So it's gonna be the same frequencies for both speakers. You wanna make sure that they're lined up correctly. So now that we're in cardioid mode, this one is going to push the audio that's usually filling the backside. It's gonna push it that way to where my crowd's at, and it's gonna create a nice full sound where my crowd is. So again, we're gonna show you a video at the end of this where you can actually see it set up, used on an event outside. And this works great for outdoor events because that's where we want the audio to be. We don't wanna be bothering the neighbors or, you know, anything going on behind us. So if you have questions on this, feel free to reach out to me. You can reach me at jeremy@djjershoptime.com. Again, it's jeremy@djjershoptime.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Every day I'm shuffling.